All right, David Harry here. And in this episode of... A Coffee with David. I'll be asking the question, GoPro, is the reason why we've been waiting around so long for this display mod is because you couldn't stop f***ing with its design. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is to show you something that I don't think anybody else has noticed yet, or if they have done, nobody's mentioned it on YouTube, and that is there are two different designs for the same thing, as in the display mod. So what it is, there's one picture that I'll show you, which comes from GoPro's own website, which is the main promotional picture at the moment for the display mod. And this picture has been around for some time now. Maybe it started getting used at the end of last year, coming into this year. Then the second picture, which is fairly unique because I've not seen it anywhere else other than on Amazon, shows a different variation of the interface for the same thing, the display mod. So let me show you. So what we're looking at right now is the picture of the display mod, which has been on the GoPro site for some time, and this is the one that's being used right now. Now what I'm going to do is switch over to the second picture, and this is the one that's on Amazon right now, so this is a more up-to-date picture. Now let me just flip between the pair of them, so I'll just kind of to and fro a little bit between them. And let's see if you can see what the differences are here, or in fact there's just one big massive difference. Now what I'm going to do is I will go close up on both of them. So as we can see right now on the left, this is a close up of the picture that's on the GoPro site right now and the picture that's been around for a long time. And on the right hand side is the one from Amazon. Now if you look carefully, what you will see is that on the left, that particular display mod does not connect to the media mod using anything other than just the HDMI port, whereas in the picture on the right, that particular display mod is connecting to the media mod using HDMI and USB. So that makes those two things completely unique. Okay, so there we have it then. Two different ways that GoPro have configured the display mod to connect to the outside world, or primarily to the media mod. Now, if the first picture was the way that it was going to come out, which we still don't know yet because I still haven't seen an unboxing of one that's been shipped, that's been sold. But if that first picture is indeed the right one, then that would kind of suggest that if it only connects via HDMI, then the display mod is just a HDMI monitor with its own built-in battery, which also means it could be used on other cameras. However, if the shipped version is the one which has got the USB-C on it as well, that might mean it can't get used for something else, and that might be the reason why GoPro have put the USB-C on with the HDMI, because don't forget, the little thing is meant to be self-powered anyway, so it definitely doesn't need to draw any power from anywhere, so that USB-C is completely redundant. However, if that USB-C was designed to send information back to the camera, as in touch information, it could mean that that little tiny display mod could be touch sensitive. Now, unfortunately, we've not seen any information about that. And I think maybe GoPro probably would have told us about this. Unless, maybe GoPro were going, do you know what? Let's make everyone dead happy. We'll sell them something which they don't know is going to be this amazing touch sensitive like little display mod until they get it. And when they put it in, they're all going to freak out and forgive us. That might be the case. I doubt it. There is another possibility here though, and that is that GoPro have done something which requires the display mod to communicate with the media mod or the Hero 8 via the media mod, and it has to use that USB socket to do it, and that may also mean that it's going to be crippled and it can't work with other things. Okay, so right now this is all conjecture, but let me know what you think of all this. But hopefully it's only going to be a couple of more days or so before the first person person gets one shipped to them to do an unboxing, and then we will see exactly what's going on. I myself have actually ordered two, one from GoPro and one from Amazon, so hopefully I'm going to get one of them. However, I still haven't had any notifications from GoPro after ordering it last week, because it was actually on the UK site for all of like 5 minutes. Actually, it was probably on for about 5 or 6 hours that I noticed, and I ordered one during that process. And also, I believe that there's been a bunch of people in North America and in other parts of the world as well who managed to get to order theirs. However, this was last week, but I've not seen nothing yet on YouTube, and today is the 14th and I've still not seen anything. Anyways, I'll carry on rabbiting on here like a complete nutter lunatic. So let me know anyway what you think in the comments of all this and what the impact could be in the operation of the display mod, and indeed what it means to the media mod and the Hero 8. And if you're into all this GoPro stuff, check out all my GoPro stuff, and you can catch all that at www.gopro9.com, which will initially link you to my playlist with all my Hero stuff in. Also as well, there'll always be links in the descriptions for all like the GoPro stuff and links to like media mods, display mods. I don't link to the light mod, I don't think, because I wasn't really dead into that. Anyways, I'm David Harry. Thank you very much for watching this video. Take care and goodbye now.